Turkles, and then old Yellowstone. I was to blame for Lieutenant Merrick's incompetence and poor seamanship. Lieutenant Merrick was the perfect officer, but not Captain Queeg. Ah, but the strawberries. That's where I had them. They laughed at me and made jokes. But I proved beyond the shadow of a doubt and with geometric logic that a duplicate key to the wardrobe icebox did exist. And I'd have produced that key if they hadn't pulled the cane out of action. I know now they were only trying to protect some fellow officer and... Naturally, I can only cover these things from memory. If I've left anything out, why, just ask me specific questions and I'll be glad to answer them one by one.
Further questions, sir. The court is closed.
For he's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow. That nobody can deny. That nobody can deny.
No, baby, no. There are no girls here. Just the officers of the cane.
For he's a jolly good fellow.
What, darling? Hey, Steve, make a pipe down, will you?
Knock it off, fellas. Old Willie's talking to his girl.
Sam, how are you?
Hi, hi.
Hello, Rabbit. How are you, fellas? Hello, Jim. Steve.
Hello, Tom. I didn't think you'd have the guts to come around.
I didn't have the guts not to. Steve. I want to thank you for not telling the fellas about what happened. Of course, I'm delighted at the way things turned out.
Stow it. It's over and done with.
Look, you can take a plane tonight. I'm getting a new ship and a new skipper, but we'll have plenty of time to get married. We'll let my mother know afterwards. Please, May. I love you, darling. I love you. Goodbye, sweetheart. Hey, Steve, Tom, that was May.
Well, well, well. The officers of the cane in happy celebration.
What are you, Barney, kind of tight?
Sure. I got a guilty conscience. I defended you, Steve, because I found the wrong man was on trial. So I torpedoed Queeg for you. I had to torpedo him. And I feel sick about it.
Okay, Barney, take it easy.
You know something? When I was studying law, and Mr. Kiefer here was writing his stories, and you, Willie, were tearing up the playing fields of dear old Princeton, who was standing guard over this fat, dumb, happy country of ours, eh? Not us. Oh, no, we knew you couldn't make any money in the service. So who did the dirty work for us? Queeg did, and a lot of other guys. Tough, sharp guys who didn't crack up like Queeg.
But no matter what, Captain Queeg endangered the ship and the lives of the men.
He didn't endanger anybody's life. You did, all of you. You're a fine bunch of officers.
You said yourself he cracked.
I'm glad you brought that up, Mr. Painter, because that's a very pretty point. You know, I left out one detail on the court-martial. Wouldn't have helped our case any. Tell me, Steve, after the Yellowstone business, Queeg came to you guys for help and you turned him down, didn't you?
Yes, we did.
You didn't approve his conduct as an officer. He wasn't worthy of your loyalty. So you turned on him. You ragged him. You made up songs about him. If you'd given Queeg the loyalty he needed, do you suppose the whole issue would have come up in the typhoon? You're an honest man, Steve. I'm asking you. Do you think it would have been necessary for you to take over?
It probably wouldn't have been necessary.
Yeah.
If that's true, then we were guilty.
Ah, you're learning, Willie. You're learning that you don't work with the captain because you like the way he parts his hair. You work with him because he's got the job or you're no good. Well, the case is over. You're all safe. It was like shooting fish in a barrel. And now we come to the man who should have stood trial. The Kane's favorite author. The Shakespeare whose testimony nearly sunk us all. Tell him, Kiefer.
No, you go ahead. You're telling it better.
You ought to read his testimony. He never even heard of Captain Queeg.
Let's forget it, Barney.
Queeg was sick. He couldn't help himself. But you, you're real healthy. Only you didn't have one-tenth the guts that he had.
Except I never fooled myself, Mr. Greenwald.
I'm going to drink a toast to you, Mr. Kiefer. From the beginning, you hated the Navy. And then you thought up this whole idea. And you managed to keep your skirts nice and starched and clean, even in the court-martial. Steve Merrick will always be remembered as a mutineer. But you, you'll publish your novel. You'll make $1 million. You marry a big movie star. And for the rest of your life, you'll live with your conscience. If you have any. Now, here's to the real author of the Kane Mutiny. Here's to you, Mr. Kiefer. If you want to do anything about it, I'll be outside. I'm a lot drunker than you are, so it'll be a fair fight.
Goodbye, darling.
Goodbye, Willie.
Yes, sir.
Take her out.
Aye, aye, sir. Single up all lines.
Single up all lines.
Stand by to cast off.